Hello friends, in this video you will watch how can you apply smoke in any video or in picture. This is a 10 second video that I was created on client requirement for the Instagram reel. Let's watch. First I am opening the Adobe After Effects, then I clicked on the new project. Then I am importing a picture where I want to apply the smoke footage. You can also use in any of your footage. After importing the picture, I bought it in timeline. Now I am going to the composition menu and selecting a composition setting. A small window pop up. First I am modifying the composition size to default size of the Instagram story, 1080x1920 pixels. 1080 is the width and 1920 is the height. Then I am changing the duration of footage. I set the 10 seconds. By doing so, frame set according to the 10 second on timeline. Then click OK. Image is small according to the composition size, so I am selecting the image layer, opening menu by clicking rightmost button, selecting transform and then fit to the composition. You can see the image was fit according to the composition size. Now I need a smoke footage to apply on this picture. So I open my browser and typing free download smoke footage. After Google for smoke footage, you can find many stock footage sites. I selected the first one with easy.com. By opening this site, you will find many footage on smoke. I am selecting this one for my video and clicking on the play button to see is it work for me or not. It is a perfect for me to apply the smoke. You can find according to your requirement. It is a fine for me and I clicked on the download button. Download ready to start and it is a saving in my computer download folder. Now downloading complete and I move it from download folder to that folder where my other assets regarding this video were already placed. You can import it by using Ctrl plus I in window or Command plus I in Mac. Or you can directly bring it to the timeline by dragging the video and placing to the timeline. I am placing it to the above of the image layer. It should be on the top of our layers to apply the effect. I am again opening the transform menu by clicking right mouse button and selecting fit to the composition. You can see the footage size was distorted. It is because this video size is a 1920x1080 pixels and our composition size is a 1080x1920. So I am undoing by using Ctrl plus Z in the Windows or Command plus Z in the Mac. And now you can fit smoke video according to the composition by dragging left position point by holding Alt key in the Windows or Option key on the Mac. By holding Alt key in the window or Option key on the Mac, your footage will fit equally. You can see the image layer was hide under the smoke layer. As you click on the eye icon, smoke layer hides and you can see the image layer. Now I am clicking again on the eye icon and unhide smoke layer. Now you can see the smoke footage by using spacebar and it is a very good video to apply. After that I am using blending mode options by opening right mouse button by selecting smoke layer, select blending mode, then select screen mode. Now you can see after selecting screen mode, smoke effect apply on the image layer. Screen is a blending mode that is used to get rid of the dark parts of your image. The screen blending mode allows you to the composite elements on a black background into your scene. So black part of the smoke layer was removed and smoke composite with the black background of the picture layer. You can see how smoke video is playing over the picture layer of makeup brush. You can use this in many areas. If you have a layer with a lot of white and you want to overlay the image and let all the white drop out, you will try screen. Now time to transform the smoke. So first I select the layer and type P. By typing P, position option will be appear in the layer panel. Then typing Shift plus R for the rotation and Shift plus T for the opacity. If you don't use Shift key with the R or any transform shortcut, it shows only that option. By using Shift key with the shortcut, the other option remained also appeared. First I am selecting position and click on the clock to create the keyframe. Also positioning the anchor where smoke will start. You can activate it from the top option bar. You can also activate it by Y key. In a practical sense, the anchor point is the point in which your layer will scale and rotate around. While it may seem silly to have an anchor point and position transform properly, both of these parameters do very different things. After that, I am decreasing the width value to place smoke in the middle of the frame by mouse over on the value box. Now I am selecting the opacity option to reduce opacity. I reduced it 100% to 70% as per requirement. I am moving playhead to the next few frames and creating another keyframe here, and I change opacity value to 50%. Keyframe is created automatically where the playhead placed. It is because we have already created the start keyframe by clicking on the clock on the start of the timeline. So when you move your playhead and change the values, keyframe will create automatically if any keyframe has created before. Again, I reducing opacity 50% to 40% on the same keyframe. I feel that 40% is a better option. Now I am selecting rotation option and created a keyframe on the same placement. Starting keyframe was already created by clicking on the clock icon as like a position option. Here I change rotation value to 0 degree to 60 degree to slightly rotate smoke on its anchor point. So starting keyframe is a default on 0 and ending keyframe value is 6 degree in rotation. Now I move the playhead on the starting keyframe and you can see the effect after hitting spacebar. After creating second frame for rotation, I moved playhead further and changed the value again according to the required animation and changed value 6 degree to minus 3.2 degree. To smooth animation, I moved keyframe to few more frames. By using Ctrl plus D in window and Command plus D in the Mac, I cut the layer where I place the playhead at the end because I don't need full smoke footage for this real video. You can see that the rest of the footage has a very dense smoke that I don't require. So I deleted the rest of the footage and duplicate the layer by using Ctrl plus D in the Windows and Command plus D in the Mac and moving the new layer at the end of the first layer. You can decrease the speed of the footage to give more slow motion effect. So select time by opening menu by clicking right button of the mouse. Select time stretch, a small window pop up, and I changing the stretch factor value 100 to 150 and click OK. By doing so, first smoke layer duration increased and layer expand according to the duration. So the value of the original layer changed and the duplicate layer has the same previous values. I deleted a duplicate layer and creating new duplicate layer by using Ctrl plus D in Windows and Command plus D in the Mac and moving the new layer at the end of the first layer. I am selecting new duplicate layer and using shortcut U. By using U shortcut, you can see all the transform options where you have created keyframes. You can see the same keyframes those I have created in the original layer, but I need here different animation. So deleted all keyframes by clicking clock icon showing in the blue for the each option. So duplicate layer has no animation at present. So making smooth transition between both layers, I selected the original layer and created two keyframes for opacity at the end of the footage. In first keyframe has the same value and in the end keyframe I change opacity to 0%. So as the duplicate layer's footage start, the original layer disappears smoothly. But transition will be complete then we do the same in the start of the duplicate layer. So I have created two keyframes in the start of the duplicate layer, but here first keyframe value is 0 and the second keyframe value is 30%. So the footage appears smoothly where the original layer disappears. Now both layers effects are very smooth. For the new animation effect, I am creating new start and keyframes for the position and rotation. Again, I move end keyframe for more frames to make animation smooth. After that, I am selecting both layers and pre-composing it, selecting pre-compose by clicking right mouse button. By doing so, both layers come together under a group. I rename it smoke. Pre-composing is the process of packaging a series of a layer into a new composition in After Effects. In a way, it is the same as grouping layers in Photoshop. By grouping these layers together, you can add animation effects or masks that will then be applied to all of the layers within. Now I am selecting the smoke composition layer and selecting time by clicking the right mouse button and then select time stretch. I am changing the value 100 to 120 to increase the duration 8 seconds to 10 seconds because our video duration is also 10 seconds. You can also change the duration value below the stretch factor box. Click OK and playing the footage again. I found that transition between both layers is not smooth as I want. You can modify your layers by clicking the pre-composed layer So I click on the smoke layer. So I move the end keyframe for opacity further. It looks better. Now again I select the smoke layer composition from the layer panel. I want when smoke come on the top of the brush, brush will brighten more with the effect of the smoke. Select the image layer and then go to the effect menu and select color correction and then select curves. Select the effects option from the layer panel and create a keyframe on the start of the footage. Drag the top point of the curves to left to increase the highlights and little drag the midpoint to increase the exposure. But we don't need it in the all footage. So I reset it and create start keyframe immediate before where I want highlights or where smoke cover the top of the brush. And creating another keyframe next to the start keyframe, select the last keyframe. When we select any keyframe, it turns to the blue. It means that keyframe is active. So I made curve adjustment on the last keyframe. Like the same, I created few more keyframes where I need to increase exposure, means where smoke come on the top of the brush. Now animation is completed. I am saving the project in the folder. This is the final video with the music. Thanks for watching.